Suppose you work for a company that sells t-shirts, and you want to create a bot that can accept orders from customers. The shirts you sell come in a limited selection of colors, so the bot itself will be relatively simplistic. Let's take a look at what the bot will do. The customer enters some text we call an utterance, text that the bot uses to extract the customer's intent. In this case, the customer wants to buy some shirts. The bot responds with a list of available colors drawn from an entity. After the customer specifies the color, size, and quantity, the bot asks for confirmation of the order and then gives pickup instructions. Let's see how to build this bot. On the bot's homepage, click New Bot to create a new bot and name it T-shirt Order Taker. Click Intent to add the first intent. Let's first add the one we think will be most commonly used, the Buy Shirt intent. Then add sample utterances. These are the phrases that make up the bot's training corpus, a list of phrases related to the intent buying t-shirts. Only 10 or so are needed to get started. Later you'll do some testing to see if the ones you've chosen make a good set of samples. An important part of the intent definition is the list of entities. Entities are like variable types. They're used in the analysis of the text input. There are two types of entities: predefined entities that are built into the bot designer, and custom entities that you create. You can create custom entities as you add them, or you can create them first in the entity designer and then add them to the intent definitions later. Let's go to the entity design page to create the color and the size entities. Both will be of type value list, so that the bot can display a list of available options to your customers. Click Entity, enter the name color, and click Value to add the values for the list. Because customers can also type in their selection as opposed to just tapping on the one they want, add some synonyms so the bot can understand typos and spelling errors. When you're done creating the color and size entities, go back to the intent design page to add the entities to the buy shirt intent. Adding the entities to the intent is optional, but if you do add them, the bot will be able to recognize the entities if they appear in the customer's input. Now it's time to train the bot. Click Train. This might take a few minutes, but after training, the bot can understand phrases that are not part of the training corpus. Let's see how the bot processes intents. Try a phrase that's not in the training corpus, such as, "I need a few red shirts." You can see that the bot has picked out a value for the color entity, which will be useful later when we design the dialogue flow. Let's add a few more intents. Add the goodbye, greeting, and return shirt intents the same way that you added the buy shirt intent. These intents have no entities associated with them. Don't forget to train the bot again after adding the new intents. Now we'll work on dialogue flow, which is the model for the user bot exchange. You define dialogue flows using OBOTML, OMC's YAML-based language. The bot is essentially a finite state machine. You must define both the states that the bot can be in and the rules for switching from one state to another. We won't show you how to build the dialogue flow from scratch. Instead, here's the complete flow, step by step. First is a bit of metadata, then the context section, where we declare the variables that we'll use in the flow. Each variable declaration has a name and a type. Here we have the variable color of type color. We defined the color type earlier. It's an entity. The others are all entity types too. Note that the variables can also have primitive types, such as integer and string, but we don't need those types in this bot. We also define a variable called input, of type NLP result. This variable holds the NLP engine's results. Then we have an optional error state to handle internal bot errors. Next, we have a list of states. We've called the first state user intent. The purpose of this state is to route the flow to the next state based on what the customer typed into the bot. If the customer wants to buy a shirt, the bot goes to the detect shirt color state. When in the detect shirt color state, the bot looks for a color entity in the customer's input, and if found, assigns it to the color variable. Then it looks for a shirt size entity, and then quantity. After looking for the entities, the bot goes through the get color, get size, and get quantity states, automatically skipping those for which it already has a value. Finally, after all the order details are known, the bot enters the confirm order state, where it waits for a yes or no response from the customer and saves it in the confirm variable. When it gets the response, the bot compares the confirm value to the string yes, and if equal, completes the transaction. You've seen how to create a simple customer service bot that does nothing but take t-shirt orders. To make it more useful, you could, for example, add the ability to take blue jean orders. You do that by adding another intent, one that allows the bot to know when the customer wants jeans instead of shirts. But for real usefulness, like providing a customer with an order number, you need to give the bot the ability to contact an API to get that number, which you can learn in the next video in the series. To learn more, visit us online at cloud.oracle.com.